we have Martin Kenny, and on the opposing side, scientist, cosmologist, Sarah Bosman. Martin, we have to go to you first of all. Why do you think it didn't happen?
Well, there's overwhelming proof that it didn't happen. I think in the past, like you're saying, we had no way of verifying anything we were told. So we saw the moon landings, well, you saw the moon landings, and you believed it, but there was no way for you to check any of it. And now we're in the age of technology, as you said, a lot of the young people believe that it was faked, and that's because they are now investigating for themselves.
I find it very interesting, and we'll talk to Sarah in a minute about the scientific side that she believes, but for me personally, I just think far too many people would have had to
cover it up.
Cover up for far too many years.
Well, how many people?
To never have slipped up.
Her people right now are taking your pensions. You don't even know about it. Do you have to cover it up? No, you don't even know. You're still buying purses as if you're gonna get that the 3K quid a month. Guess what, babbler? You're not.
How many people have supposedly gone beyond low Earth orbit, beyond 200 miles off the Earth?
No idea.
24. The entire history of humanity.
But what? But
24 people.
So your point is
what, only 24.
But
so
what I'm saying is there was a whole control center, operations center, backup control, all sorts of things.
Do you know what happens in the finance department of ITV?
In the finance department?
No idea. Do you know what happens? Do you know what happens in the executive office of ITV, right at the top?
No, but if somebody was covering something up,
they tell you nothing. Exactly.
Yeah, but
if something did happen,
but if somebody's covering something up, everybody would have to cover it up.
So you guys knew about Jimmy Savile when he was working closely with your very company and all the royals. You know he was banging kids when they were dead.
Because you would know
Sarah,
about it.
Sarah, what do you think?
Well, there are also a lot of engineers, of course, working on these for years and years. They had to come into their job every morning thinking they were developing a rocket. And that's thousands of people being involved in the development and the testing and the labs, people overseeing the labs. It's not only the 24 people who actually went off the Earth.
The only way we can discern whether this happened or not is by analysing and studying the actual data that was taken during those Apollo missions. Right? The scientific data.
That's not true.
Hold on. Let me finish.
Like how the world let you guys finish in the Holodomor.
So that's the telemetry data, right? So during those 4 years that they did the Apollo missions, they collected loads of data, you know, biometrical data, design blueprints, etc., etc. Right. To end this, if we had the data now, and we could scrutinize it, if we could test it, which is the scientific method.
Ah, genius, Martin. Which is the scientific method? I'm having a blast. Look at those stupid glasses. What a retard.
Test it, observe, and research. Not only has it not been released, NASA destroyed it.
Well, or lost
Why would they have destroyed it?
NASA hang on. Donald Petit, NASA astronaut and chemical engineer. This is a direct quote.
His name's Don Petit because he's mentally small. Hilarious. Classic bike returner. Seeing some gravel where I didn't see it. Nice, Martin.
Okay. I'd go to the moon in a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. Right. We used to, we destroyed the technology, and it's a painful process to build up again.
Oh, you're in that context, absolutely. In that context, absolutely. I completely agree with him. The technology we had at the time was so ridiculously obsolete. There was nothing we could do with it anymore. It's like if you have a car from 60 years ago that was unique, if you try to repair all the parts one by one, it's going to take you way too much money. We don't run cars that way anymore. It was scrapped eventually because it was just too outdated. So, of course, it was destroyed, the technology in that sense. We don't have it anymore. It wouldn't run.
But, Sarah, we got the technology together to go there. Why haven't we been back since, the 70s?
That guy's getting it.
I think it comes down to the funding. I think
$58 million
after
a day.
America went to the moon a few times, the people in power told the voters, why are we spending all so much money on this? Why don't we elect a party who will put our taxes to do something else? And unfortunately, it was the last time in history where so much of your taxes went to science and research and technology. It's been cut down a lot, I think, mostly for political reasons.
What do you think the moon is made of?
What I know the moon is, it's a luminary. That's all I know.
What? It shines?
It's a luminary. It's a luminary of some sort. So I can't go beyond that. You know, you've got a P900 camera now you can buy for under £1,000.
Yeah.
And you can zoom in to the moon. That's supposed to be, by the way, 238,000 miles away in deep dark space, and yet you can zoom in quite close in detail with a commercial camera. And people have taken photographs and images showing it sometimes translucent. You can see through it, right? Sometimes it's got something called a lunar wave. There are many videos showing the moon with a lunar wave.
He's shouting out my nigga Crow 777.
We don't know what that is. It's all a mystery.
So you believe you couldn't possibly land on it because it's
absolutely
not solid?
Not.
If it isn't true, is he really doing any harm or is it just an interesting theory?
There's nothing wrong with people looking at data themselves and looking at buying their own cameras and taking their own data and so on. I think the main problem with the moon conspiracy is that the people involved that would have to cover it up now also involve people in Japan with this new satellite, people in Russia, people in Australia, who would all have to be covering up when they do this follow-up. America, why would they be covering up what America did 50 years ago?
It's almost like there's an international group of cosmopolitan elite who function outside of the construct of countries. Huh. Judging by the beak on old Mrs. Potato Head over there, I think she knows exactly who I'm referring to. This is how we do it.